Hello. Yes, you guessed it right. It is Christmas, almost Christmas time. I'm jumping the gun. It's almost Christmas time, but not yet. Welcome to our service for today. I hope that you've had an awesome week. Exams should be done for most of you, right? So you are able to relax and just enjoy. If you have one or two more left, just keep pushing. Just keep pushing. You are at the finish line. You're almost there. Okay. If you've had a birthday this past week, I'm wishing you hope that you did have a blessed one and that you got to spend it with your family, with friends, whether it was at school or at home, wherever, that you had to have an awesome time. And if you have a birthday coming up this week, we shall wish you next week, all right? Let us pray. Heavenly Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord God, that you are with us through it all. Lord God, as we enter the season of Advent, Lord God, we come, Lord God, with joy. We come, Lord God, with expectation. Lord God, with hope, looking forward to reimagining and reliving that good old story of Christmas, Lord God, of being reminded of how you came to this world to be one of us, so that you can just live among us. So that you can show us who you are and what you want of us. And so, Lord God, we come to this service, Lord God, and we just pray and ask that you continue to speak to us, that you continue to teach us by your Holy Spirit in us, and that you lead us, Lord God, in holiness and in love. In your name we pray, now and always. Amen. Alrighty, so it's time for our worship now. No, it's not really a Christmas carol yet. Maybe next week, but it is still a Christmas song. And so I hope that you are able to just worship the Lord your God with this song and that you are able to connect with Him. And so enjoy. Here's the worship song for today.
In Bethlehem, one holy night, a host of angels filled the sky. They sang to tell the world who waits, our Savior comes this Christmas day.
Emmanuel, He shall reign.
You're the hope of Israel.
Awesome. Welcome back. Welcome back. It is finally December. Yay. The year is almost done. A month of rest and celebration for so many people around the world has eventually started. I'm excited, if you can't tell. I hope that you are also excited, right? But December for us Christians is even more special. And no, it's not about this, right? It's not about Santa or anything. But it is about the Savior of the world coming to us. Jesus Christ being born to us. This is what we celebrate. This is what we look forward to. This is what makes our hearts joyful and filled with gladness, right? And so today we begin a season in the church calendar called Advent, right? And so Advent is 4 weeks that lead up to Christmas. It is an opportunity for us to prepare for Jesus to come into our midst, to prepare for God to become human just like us. It is a time when we get ready to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ and to wait in anticipation for his return. Advent reminds us of what is important, and prepares us of what is to come as well. So the first Sunday of Advent is all about hope. It is all about hope, right? As we wait expectantly, we wait with hope. Now, before the birth of Jesus, the people were waiting for the hope of the nation. They were waiting for that person who was promised to them, the Messiah. They were waiting for the one who would come and bring freedom and peace for the land, the one who would come and save them. And so for our first reading for today, we read from the Old Testament, from the prophet Isaiah, right? We read from Isaiah chapter 64, verse 1 to 9. That's Isaiah 64, verse 1 to 9. And it reads as follows. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down, that the mountains would tremble before you, as when fire sets twigs ablaze and causes water to boil. Come down to make your name known to your enemies and cause the nations to quake before you. For when you did awesome things that we did not expect, you came down and the mountains trembled before you. Since ancient times, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who acts on behalf of those who wait for him. You come to the help of those who gladly do right, who remember your ways. But when we continued to sin against them, you were angry. How then can we be saved? All of us have become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous acts are like filthy rags. We all shrivel up like a leaf, and like the wind, our sins sweep us away. No one calls on your name or strives to lay hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have given us over to our sins. Yet you, Lord, are our Father. We are the clay. You are the potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be angry beyond measure, Lord. Do not remember our sins forever. Oh, look on us, we pray, for we are your people. Thanks be to God for his word. Might seem like a bit of a somber reading for Christmas. But just think about the fact that they were waiting for God. They were waiting to see the hope of the nation come into the world. In the reading, we see Isaiah prays for God to come down. Prays for God to come down and break the barrier that seems to be keeping his presence away from the people. Isaiah wants God to come down like the times of old and step in, intervene, and act like he always has. Isaiah acknowledges that the nation has sinned, that the nation has sinned, and that God will shine his face on them again. He has this hope. He acknowledges that the people have turned away from God. He acknowledges that the people have lived in disobedience to him and his words. And due to their unrighteousness, God's face does not shine on them anymore. However, through all of this, Isaiah still has hope. He still has hope that God would come and shine his face on them again. He has hope that he will forgive their sins and bring salvation to the people once more, and that they will become his children again, and God will be their father. For years, the Israelites had this hope. They had this hope that God would send someone to bring salvation, and they waited, and they waited for what seemed to be forever. For years, they waited for this. But then, on one night in the little town of Bethlehem, hope was rekindled as God came down to the people and became one of them, a human, a little baby boy. And so Jesus was born, God incarnate. He was born, and the hope of the world was made and made its dwelling among us, lived among us. The one that the prophet spoke of was finally here. He had finally arrived. He had finally come. The one that many people waited for so long, but yet had no opportunity to witness him, was here. All these people waited in hope. They waited in hope because they knew that God is faithful and that God will fulfill his promises forever and ever. And so we, like those of old, also wait in hope for the return of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We wait in hope, trusting in the faithful God. We wait in expectation for what Jesus said would happen. Jesus told us how we should wait for his return. We read from Mark chapter 13, verse 32 to 37. And Jesus is speaking here, the day and hour unknown. But about that day or hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Be on guard. Be alert. You do not know when that time will come. It's like a man going away. He leaves his house and puts his servants in charge, each with their assigned task, and tells the one at the door to keep watch. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know when the owner of the house will come. You do not know when the owner of the house will come back, whether in the evening or at midnight, or when the rooster crows or at dawn. If he comes suddenly, do not let him find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to everyone. Watch. Thanks be to God for his word. Jesus tells us to watch. And so how should we wait for the return of him? We should wait in hope. We should wait in anticipation, knowing that he will fulfill his promise. We should wait in prayer, being alert at all times, seeking God at all times. We should wait by not being led astray by false teachings and all these things that want to drag us away from God. We should wait in the presence of God. We should wait by being in God, and we should wait in faith, having faith and placing our faith in God. That is how those of old lived. They waited for God. They waited for the Messiah. They waited for him to send someone down, and God did. And so we too wait. We wait in hope, knowing that God does not disappoint, but that he is faithful. And so we wait this Christmas as well. This Christmas season, as you sit with your family and friends, as you hear and you read again the story of Christmas, the birth of Christ, may you be filled with hope from God. May you be filled with hope from God, knowing that that the waiting is never in vain, and that he is faithful. Waiting, knowing that he who is faithful will complete all that he has promised. To God be the glory, now and always. Amen. Let us pray. And so, Heavenly Lord, we wait in hope. We wait, Lord God, in anticipation. As we enter this Christmas season, Lord God, we give thanks and praise to you. We thank you, Lord God, for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, into this world to make his dwelling among us, to live as one of us, to show us what it means to live as one who has faith. Lord God, we thank you that you never disappoint, but that you are faithful, and that we can place our faith and our hope in you. And so, Heavenly Lord, we place our faith and hope in you as we wait in hope and in expectation in anticipation, waiting for your return, Lord God, waiting for the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so, Lord God, help us to be patient in our waiting. Help us, Lord God, to look to you, to stand guard, to be alert, to wait, Lord God, in faith, to seek you at all times. Help us, Lord God, to wait in hope and to have hope in you. And so continue to be with us this week. Continue to show us your grace, your love, and your mercy. And Lord God, during this festive season, Lord God, we pray for safety. We pray for protection, Lord God. We pray for wisdom for those who will be on the roads, for those who will be celebrating in all forms, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for your wisdom to be with them. We pray, Lord God, that you might protect them, that you open their eyes, Lord God, that they might see what is right and what is good, and that they might do what is right and what is good. And so, Lord God, we ask that you be with your people during this time. In your name we pray, now and always. Amen. Awesome. Thanks, guys, for joining again this week. I hope that you are getting as excited as I am for Christmas and that you will continue to wait for the Lord our God to return in hope and in anticipation. Have an awesome week, and I'll see you again next week online. Cheers.